Hi, let's talk a little more about privilege today. So, when I was in law school, I was watching TV in the common area in the cafeteria, and a black man had gotten shot. I don't remember which one. Sadly, there are way too many to keep track of, and it makes me cry. And there were two black men next to me, and we were watching this together, and at the same time, when the black man in the on the news segment reached behind him to get his wallet, when the cop told him to, and of course he got shot shortly thereafter, both men were like, "Oh, you never reach for your wallet. You never, ever, ever reach for your wallet. Everybody knows that." And I was like, "What are you talking about? Not everybody knows that. I've never heard that. You do what the cop tells you to do." And they were like, and one of them said, "Every black man knows that you don't reach for your wallet, even if the cop tells you to." And I was like, it blew me away. The cop told him to get his wallet, and these black men were like, "You'd never reach for your wallet." Keep in mind, this is law school, so these men are educated. They have college degrees. They come from fairly well enough to do backgrounds that they've gotten through college and they're now in law school. No matter how crappy your background is, no matter how poor you are, if you get into law school, you're fairly privileged. Law school, medical school, grad school, any of that, you're fairly privileged. It means you could get a loan. It means you had money, or you could get a loan. It means you're educated. It means you can pass standardized tests well enough. You have fairly decent privileges if you can get into law school. So these are men in law school with me. And they're like, "You never reach for your wallet." And I was like, "Wow, that's it would never occur to me to not do exactly what the cop says." And they're like, "Of course it doesn't. You're white." And this was back when I thought that the word privilege meant racist. And I was like, "I'm not racist." And they're like, "No, you're not." And they one of them had said, "You're privileged. You've got white privilege." And I was like, "I'm not racist." And one of them's like, "No, we don't think you are. But you're blinded, you're shielded from racism." And I was like, "We live in the same world. I'm not shielded from racism. I see it every day." And the other one said, "You're shielded from racism the way we're shielded from sexism." Boom. Right in the gut. I got it. When I was raped and I was telling the cop, "I know it's not my fault," he said, "That's good. Most women don't." And I said, "Of course they don't. We're taught since birth that it's not, that it's our fault, that we could have prevented it, that we have control over men's actions, that it depends on what we wear, that it's our fault." And the look on his face was so surprised that, "What? Women are taught that it's their fault?" And then I was surprised, like, "Don't we live in the same world?" "Yeah, we do, but we don't. Men don't hear the message, 'It's your fault,' day in and day out. Whites don't hear the message, 'Don't reach for your wallet.'" Boom, I got it. So, yeah, privilege doesn't mean racist, it doesn't mean sexist, it means you're shielded.